See, the UK is the main player here in this crisis. It is the country that the migrants are trying to go to when they cross the channel. But there was this dust-up over the past couple days. This meeting was originally supposed to include the UK's Home Affairs Minister Priti Patel, but she was uninvited after UK Prime Minister Boris Johnson sent a public letter to French President Emmanuel Macron. There were two reasons why this letter made the French angry. One is that it was apparently the complete opposite of what Johnson had said to President Emmanuel Macron in a phone call the previous day, or earlier that day, rather. And the other reason it angered them is because it's asking the French and EU countries in general to take back migrants that have crossed the channel. And that is a violation of international law and a number of understandings. The problem is that since Brexit, the UK no longer has a framework to deal with migration with its EU neighbors. The Dublin regulation no longer applies. And the UK has been trying to form some kind of new agreement with the EU or with France bilaterally in order to come to an understanding about how to deal with these migrant crossings and return them. But of course, that an agreement hasn't been reached yet. And of course, they're not going to come any closer to an agreement by the UK not being at this summit today. That being said, there is plenty for these three ministers from France, from Belgium, and from the Netherlands, plus their EU counterparts from the European Commission to try to agree here to fix the situation. And they can come up with kind of a joint push to the rest of the EU countries to try to find some kind of replacement for the Dublin regulation, which they've been trying for many years, unsuccessfully since the migrant crisis of 5 years ago. But of course, even if they come to an understanding about migration within the EU, that doesn't help the situation with the UK, to which any type of migrant agreement for the EU would not apply.